Thank you very much for joining us. My name is John Westcott. I run the alliances and marketing groups at Zixi. Today, I am joined by Eric Itbrink, Technical Product Manager at Erdetto, and Natram Dionarain, Senior Sales Engineer for Partnerships. And these guys are going to give us an introduction to Zixi, an introduction to Erdetto, and an overview of our new integration for content production and the forensic watermarking of live video streams. We will be taking questions at the end, so please put anything that you have in the Q&A window. We will get to as many of those as we can at the end, but if we are unable to get to your question, we are logging your name and email address along with your question, and the appropriate person from Erdetto or Zixi will follow up with you appropriately. Towards the end, we will open a poll as well that will give you the option to ask for a contact from Zixi, a contact from Erdetto, or if you have a potential project for this integration, then you can request a joint solutions meeting. So with that, I'd like to turn it over to Natram Dionarain, who is going to give a brief intro to Zixi. Natram, good morning.
Good morning, thanks John. Zixi started 13 years ago as a protocol for mostly point-to-point video transport. About 3 years ago, we evolved into a software-defined video platform that's servicing top broadcasters, service providers, and OTT platforms. Our clients are using our solutions to transport content across any network, whether it's managed or unmanaged. Using our Zixi ZenMaster control plane, our customers are able to orchestrate and view telemetry data of the entire video workflow. So what is a software-defined video platform? Well, the Zixi software-defined video platform consists of four parts. First, we have the protocols. We believe the Zixi protocol is the best in class. We spent the first 10 years hardening our protocol with a number of unique features such as DTLS, dynamic FEC, and we even can save bandwidth on certain types of streams. We realized that some workflows require other protocols, so our software-defined video platform is the only platform that supports 17 protocols. NDI and WebRTC are the newest additions just announced in the second quarter as a result of what's going on in the world today. Second is the video solution stack. We've built around the protocols, these solutions leverage the underlying hardware to provide more out of the same software platform, such as transcoding, packaging, time delay or time shifting, and the analytics. The third part of this platform is ZenMaster, which ties all the protocols and solutions together. ZenMaster alleviates the need to have both broadcast and IT engineers working together to set up your video workflow. Now, with a few clicks of the mouse, any operator can spin up a workflow or even test out new cloud solutions from one of our partners. The fourth and final piece of the platform is the Zixi enabled network, which consists of over 180 tech partners, 700 customers across 100 countries, running over 100,000 Zixi instances. 100,000 Zixi instances, to put that number in context, the largest CDN has 275,000 edge nodes. So Zixi is like a small CDN for broadcast video. Of the 700 customers using Zixi today, here are the top publishers running their video business on our platform. We have over 180 technology partners that have either integrated Zixi into their device, software platform, or has standardized on Zixi as part of the service offering. When you tie all those logos together, you have an industry that speaks the same language, Zixi. Starting in the upper left, you have the service providers running Zixi to support their end customers, who are the content owners. The content owners are also running on Zixi. They can leverage any cloud or any Zixi powered device to deliver content into any OTT platforms or cable headends. On the right side of this slide, you can see some of our newest customers and partners. Today, we're announcing our first anti-piracy partnership with the Adero Tracemark solution. So how are these customers using Zixi? Here are the top five use cases for how the industry is using Zixi. The first one is satellite rationalization. With the recent changes to satellite spectrum in the US, content owners need a new way to distribute their content. This is where they turn to Zixi for a cost-effective replacement that is as reliable as satellite. The second is content exchange. With Zixi, content owners have more flexibility to deliver the product to new endpoints without the need to provision satellite or fiber transport, such as, you know, sending video from one state to another or from one country to the other. It becomes a lot easier with Zixi. Remote monitoring. Clients can deploy Zixi software to act as probes across their video network. These probes will enable operators to remotely monitor the video, receive alerts on issues, or simply do a quick QC check to view the content, all from the browser. New revenue sources. Content owners can test the waters on new distribution endpoints with a few clicks while keeping the initial investment costs low. And finally, cloud virtualization. A lot of industries have benefited from the on-demand nature of the cloud. Now Zixi is enabling our customers to easily leverage the same resources without the need to hire a team of IT engineers. Now that you know all about Zixi, I'll turn it over to Eric to tell you a little bit about Ergetto.
Okay, hi everyone. My name is Erik Hietbrink. I'm based in the Netherlands, working for Irdeto. I would like to thank Zixi for this opportunity to present this integrated solution that we have developed for protecting live video. So first, something about Irdeto. Next slide. So Irdeto has been operating in the digital platform security market for quite a while. We're a 50-year-old company. We started out as conditional access. We've since then expanded in other regions, such as beyond video entertainment, such as video games protection, connected transport, connected health, and various other IoT connected industries, where we are able to leverage our security expertise to protect revenue of our customers and fight cybercrime and allow customers with the higher security to create new offerings. Next slide, please. So as an organization, we have a worldwide customer base. We are present in over 15 locations in the world with development centers. Most of our roughly 1,000 employees are engaged in engineering research and development. So we're a very technology focused company, and that shows in our offerings. We're serving over 400 customers worldwide, and some of the top brands you saw in the names. What we believe is that security is not a single-sided approach, and we try to cover, protect, and help our customers in all aspects. So our portfolio addresses the entire chain from content owners all the way down to consumers. So how do we help those customers? So we have solutions to secure production, content aggregation, the distribution, the consumption, but also what happens thereafter. So on the right, you see a list of the services that we offer in our video entertainment market unit. That ranges from cyber services, which is sort of the detective work, online detective work, finding out where criminals behave, from app security that's protecting, obfuscating code so that it cannot be debugged, etc., by pirates trying to steal secrets in the software, Armor, that's an automated service around that, keys and credentials are things protecting keys that gets provisioned into devices, set-top boxes, DRM key keys, etc., that can all be centrally arranged in a vendor agnostic way. Our traditional conditional access, protecting broadcast, video delivery via satellite or cable. Our rights solutions, offering DRM, multi-DRM systems. We have Media Manager that can help with content preparation. We have our piracy control department, which connected to that is our online piracy detection services. These organizations help customers identify where piracy is actually occurring and help them trace the sources of that piracy. We have Trusted Home that focuses on securing the home gateways, the routers, the set-top boxes that are in the customer's home. And last but not least, we have watermarking, which is the subject of our integration today with Zixi. Next slide, please. So our joint customers, they're faced with a growing piracy of their high-value content. So pirate organizations or individuals are illegally streaming live events and are making money off that. These streaming services typically work on a wide variety of devices, smartphones, tablets, smart TVs, etc. And it is very easy for the general consumer to purchase these devices or to get access to illegal content. So there's a very low threshold. So piracy is hurting the industry. So pirates are a direct competitor for the operators or even the content owners that are trying to make money off their content. This is actually a profitable business for pirates. They run their own business models, etc. as well. And they wouldn't be doing that if they wouldn't be making money out of this. So we see also content theft is largely untracked. In various companies, there's a growing awareness that their content is illegally redistributed and that they're actually suffering from that monetary. They see a direct impact on the bottom line revenue that they get. They see an impact on their brands, etc. They see that in content owners, for instance, in negotiations with their clients for selling their brand rights, their content, they see an impact if that content is widely available on pirate networks. So there's a direct impact on their revenue. Next slide, please. To quantify this a bit more, let's give some numbers. On the left side, you see two examples of piracy operations that Irdeto helped to roll up in the last year. And you can see those are quite significant numbers that these small pirate organizations were actually achieving. So with small, I mean, there's only a few individuals that are behind this, but they're able to serve a very large amount of pirate consumers. And based on the police raids that have been done and the analysis on the financials of the pirates, we are able to identify that they were making many, many millions a year in profits. And that actually is profits that could have gone to the content owners, to the operators, but it's also a direct loss because the content owners, they're losing subscribers, the subscriber churn, and that's all driving down the bottom line for these operators. Another side to view the impact is by a number of investigations that have been done. A couple of studies done by the IOPU in Europe indicated, for instance, that in 2018, there was a 1 billion euros lost in earned in revenue by illegal IPTV services across the continent. A further study by Parks Associates indicates this by 2024, this market could grow to worldwide 12.5 billion. So these are no small numbers that we're working with. Next slide, please. So because IDAT also offers online piracy detection services, we have a pulse on what's happening in the market. What we see, for instance, during this COVID period is that live streaming is, of course, at the lowest ever. And so also is the piracy of live streaming. We're seeing that behavior of consumers is changing. They're rapidly turning to pirate services, not only because they are searching for all kinds of content that are not an immediate offer for with operators, but also because you see some operators lowering quality. And the pirate quality is just always top notch. They can offer the highest quality. So there's a large increase in piracy. We expect that this piracy remains high even when the COVID measures are being reduced and halted and sports resumes. Okay, next slide, please. Okay, so what do we do to combat this piracy and to secure your live streaming content? So one of the core defenses that you have against that is watermarking. The IDETO watermarking solution is called Tracemark. And what we are showing today is the Tracemark for live distribution. IDETO also has other watermarking offerings that are addressed primarily at operators that deliver to end consumers. Those are Tracemark for OTT or Tracemark for our broadcast customers. These solutions are after identifying the actual end consumer that is sharing a video stream. What this solution is aimed at is we are trying to identify the distributors to which these live streams are being distributed to. So if, for instance, if you have a live stream of a Super Bowl, for instance, that you're distributing to various operators around the country or around the world, and you're doing that via the Zixi streaming platform, then we can now embed a watermark in the stream that goes out to a particular operator. And when content is being pirated from that operator and we find it back, we can identify via which operator that came from. That enables then the content operator to further analyze what to do as a next offensive step against the piracy. So he could engage with that operator for further watermarking measures, etc. But it always starts with the first step, where is the content actually coming from? And that is what this solution is allowing. Next step, please. Okay, so watermarking is not a standalone thing. We are embedding it in the content and it's of no use and putting a watermark in if you cannot get it out again. So as part of the end-to-end workflow, not only with our integration now, we offer a method to embed the watermark. There's also opportunity for a customer to engage with an online piracy detection service to find which of their content is being pirated, how prevalent is the piracy, and based on that decide what to do as a next step, what security measures to implement besides this distributor watermarking, but maybe go to a next step, identify session level watermarking, identify DRM improvements, things like that. If content is being found by the online piracy detection service, IDETO offers a online portal to do your detection. So what happens there, you upload content that you have recorded, or you point the detection service to a live video stream that you've identified in the wild. And based on that input, the detection service will then analyze the content and present the watermark that has been detected. Yeah. Next slide, please. So what is actually the content that is being put into the video signal? So when we embed a watermark, we are changing the video content. We can do that on by doing as a means of video plugin in an encoder, or we can do it in a post encoder solution. With the Zixi integration, we've chosen to go for a post encoder solution, which allows us to create this integration in a very short amount of time. It's a scalable solution because we can instantiate as many embedders as we want in the cloud, because that's where the whole solution resides. The value that we put inside the content is something that can identify, for instance, the source stream that is coming into the Zixi platform. So everything coming from a certain source, we can identify. That is one use case in which we can deploy this solution. The other solution is we can identify each channel that is going through the Zixi HLS transcoder. And the third way, we can embed a watermark that is unique for each HLS channel endpoint. Yeah. The watermark that is being embedded is a direct ID. So that means that we can observe the content a very short amount of time and then extract immediately the final identity out of the content. Yeah. This means that we only need a very short amount of content, recorded or observable content, to identify the source. Next slide, please. Okay, Netrem will now explain a bit more about the architecture that we have implemented in the solution. Netrem?
Thanks, Eric. So on the first box here, we have the content production. So think of this as a Zixi feeder, where you have a live linear content, so a live channel that's constantly being distributed, or you have an event-based live stream that's coming in. And that is typically starts at a distribution point, and then it hits a Zixi broadcaster. The broadcaster can run on-prem or in a cloud. In this instance, we're running it in the cloud, and we're running it right next to the Irdeto segment embedder. The broadcaster is taking that Zixi input stream and converting it into HLS, or transcoding it, I should say, into HLS. And then we're passing that into the Irdeto segment embedder. And then we pull that HLS back out, we repackage it, and then we send it down to a publish point, whether that's an origin or a CDN. That's typically where it gets published to as a Zixi handoff before going further on to either mobile devices, TVs, or set-top boxes. And that's pretty much, you know, the integration from a Zixi perspective. Eric, do you want to talk a little bit about the embedding? Guessing that's a no.
Yeah, sorry, I was on mute. So now I'm just mentioning we are doing a post encode embedder that we where we embed the content. We analyze the HLS segments. We select the video frames that can carry the watermark, and then we modify that with our watermarked version of that content. And we currently have the HLS, but the same principle works for transport streams, etc. That's something we'll touch on later.
Yeah. Okay, thanks. And now we'll jump into a quick demo of Zixi Zen Master, where we're showing you how this process is done. So this is Zen Master. This is Zixi's orchestration plane, where you can set up a number of different workflows. In this instance, we're looking at an HLS transcode workflow. So this is very similar to the diagram we looked at, where sources coming in, it's hitting a broadcaster, and then we're actually transcoding in the cloud here into four different renditions. And I'm able to play any of these right here in the browser. So this is the video coming in, being transcoded. As you can see, it's a live broadcast. And then, as I mentioned earlier, this video is being passed into the Irdedu watermark system. And from there, we're pulling it back out into ZenMaster. So let's click on this. So this is the post watermark where we've pulled each rendition back into ZenMaster. And then we're packaging those up on the same broadcaster and then publishing that out to an origin. And now if I were to play this content, you'll see it looks pretty much exactly the same. The watermark is invisible, and we're able to capture the analytics of this publishing to the endpoint. That's pretty much the workflow I wanted to show from ZenMaster perspective. I'll pass the share over to Eric, where he'll show how to detect this watermark within the stream.
Okay, so what you see here is the Irdedu Iris portal. So this is a central point of entry for all our services, basically, covering all the others that I mentioned, the keys and credentials, the DRM, etc. One of them is our watermarking section. So when you enter our watermarking detection service, you are basically presented with a dashboard that shows some statistics of past jobs that you have done. The area of interest is the detections. So here you see basically a list of all the detections that you have performed in the past. If we are doing also, for instance, the online piracy detection service for you, this service can be integrated in the reporting that you do, but it's also available as a standalone for customers that want to do their own anti-piracy detection. What you see here, if you want to add content for detection, you either have a choice to add a pre-recorded video, and that would look very simple. You can add files and you can add, for instance, multiple video files. These are, for instance, recordings we made earlier from the live playout that Zixi has been just showing. And they can start up. So what happens now is this cloud service will start up an processing instance in the cloud, which will run a detection on these video files. Startup of these is usually a minute or so, as you know that in AWS, etc., the startup of a VM takes some time. The alternative is you can enter a live URL. So this is the URL that was playing the watermark video. And that one will also be showing in the GUI. There we are, we can start. The difference in the GUI at the moment is that if it's a live stream, it will show, and I will show a prior recording, it will show 50% progress at the moment, because it's a live stream. It's not able to tell when we'll finish. So this is, at the moment, we can do a manual stop when we have detected the payload. What you will see when you go into the details, you'll see a screenshot taken from the stream. So you can see that it's actually the intended stream. You can get some statistics about the video, duration, etc. The most important thing that you'll see is the ID that is being detected. So this is the ID that you can get out of the video. With this ID, you can go back into the configuration that you did in the Zixi component and find back what the originator was of this pirate stream. Yeah. we can go, for instance, to a video file. So in a video file, you can see, for instance, that this is actually a very short duration of content, 4 seconds. So normally we are not recommending to make recordings this short to do detection, because if pirates do a lot of transcoding and attacks or a camcorder, etc., we will need a bit more content to make a robust detection. But in this case, we're able to detect the identity of the content very quickly. Okay, now this one is starting and it will quickly detect on the content. But basically, this is all there is to see on the detection portal. We try to keep it as simple as possible and as dedicated to what's actually needed for the customer as possible. If there are videos that are not detecting, then there's an opportunity to escalate this to the Idetto support team, and we can take a manual analysis of the video and then usually come to a detection result. Okay. So back to you, Netram.
Thanks, Eric. Jump back into the... this. So now some key takeaways from our webinar today.
Okay. So what we try to do with this solution is to offer customers a very easy way to add live distributed watermarking to their solution. So in the past years, watermarking has been around for quite a while. One of the hurdles that we as Idetto always ran into was that it's very complex to integrate things into a workflow. Existing workflows depend on all kinds of equipment or software that has been carefully tuned and carefully set up. With this solution, we try to make it a very fast deployment for you. If you're using Zixi, we can very quickly add this solution to your existing Zixi workflows. It's also the ease of use. You saw the GUI that Netram showed. It takes remarkably little configuration to get going with this solution. And yeah, it really helps to take the complexity out of what watermarking is. For the end user, there's no change in experience. They still get the same performance from the Zixi protocol. They get the live video and the watermarks are invisible. So for the end user, there's no change. So what we showed in this demo was a HLS setup, but we're working also on bringing you a transport stream solution soon. And the last part, we can also offer this integrated with an online piracy detection service, but also the strong point of this solution is that it also leaves the customer completely free to choose their own piracy service for this solution. So all in all, it's a simple, easy, and fast way for customers to get started with distributor watermarking. Okay, next slide.
All right, guys, thank you very much. We'll now enter into the Q&A session. If you have any questions, please put them into the Q&A tab and we will get to as many as we can. We've had several questions here around latency that we'll put to Netram and Eric. What latency does this introduce into the watermark and the live broadcast? Does Zixi affect the Erdetto marketing? Oh, watermarking. Sorry.
Thanks, John. I'll do the FEC and the HLS version, and then Eric can add a little bit after that. So the Zixi FEC is before the watermarking. So essentially, forward error correction is part of the transport stream. And then we apply the watermarking after the HLS transcode. So they're two different and separate things. So the second part of latency, our transcoder is about 200 milliseconds. So it's a very fast transcoder, transcoder HLS. The packaging after the watermark is done is what will take the most time. I don't have any hard numbers on how long our packaging is, but that's probably the piece that will take the longest time in terms of adding latency to the end-to-end stream.
Yeah, if I may add to that. So if you're talking HLS, so our post encode solution is currently taking a 1 second video segment delay because we have to ingest the thing and output it again. And that's also why we're working on going to the UDP MPEG-2 transport stream processing, which will reduce that delay further.
All right, a question for Eric. How many operators can you define with this trace mark, and how would that reflect to your billing model?
So in this model, since we're doing this in the cloud, we can scale to as many as is possible in the AWS networking interface. So we can do many tens of different distributors in this solution. Cost model, there is a scaling factor that is involved, but for further costing details, etc. Yeah, feel free to reach out afterwards directly to eData.
What happens to the watermarking if the videos have been transcoded or encoded by pirates? Will it disappear?
Absolutely not. So a watermark, that's the main purpose of a watermark, to be able to survive all kinds of transformations that are being applied either intentionally or unintentionally on the video. So just transcoding a watermark to another bitrate or a video to another bitrate or resolution is actually an attack on the content. You're degrading the quality of the content. And with the content, you're also degrading the quality of the watermark. But the watermark is designed in such a way that it's able to survive a great number of such transformations. And the purpose is that the watermark survives as long as you're basically able to see the video in a reasonable quality. The watermark will survive as well. If you see only square pixels, then yeah, it's maybe not content worth watching anyway. And then of course the robustness of the watermark suffers as well. So there's a trade-off between quality and robustness, but in general, the watermark is aimed at being as robust as possible.
And a follow-up to that, how much video is required in order to extract the watermark?
So what you saw in the demo is that we actually detected from a 4 second video, which is an extremely short case. But since we're embedding a direct identity, so that means a one-shot identity, we're able to do that in relatively short time. The maximum that we would say, if we haven't detected in say 5 minutes of video, then it is beyond our capability of detecting the content. So for sure, we detect within five minutes. And as you saw in the demo, as short as 4 seconds is also possible.
Another question, you showed how to detect the watermark, but how do you track and know where it has been pirated?
So this is something that you can do in the configuration of the Zixi GUI. So one of the things we will work on in the future is to improve scalability, improve the GUI feedback that we can offer to the end user, where we can make this a simple lookup across all the installed streams in the GUI.
All right, following up on the previous FEC question, If the FEC packets are used on the receiving end, will they degrade the watermark at all?
So in terms of FEC, that's for the ZXI portion of the transport. Once the watermark is applied, that is an HLS version. So FEC is not being used there. For HLS, we're using HTTP to transmit that to the origin. In terms of, you know, doing a straight ZXI watermark, that is something that we're working with Arterio on for the future, where we'll be able to watermark broadcast streams coming in and going to different endpoints. And at that point, the watermark and FEC will have some latency additions to the time it takes to go from point to point. So we're still working on that integration. That's something that we'll announce at a later point.
All right, that appears to be all of our questions. So I would like to thank Eric and Natrum and our audience for taking the time out to talk with us about content production and the forensic watermarking of live stream solutions. Some people have filled out the poll for a follow-up. Please have a look and let us know how would you would like to be contacted. And other than that, we appreciate your time and look forward to speaking with you again soon. Thank you.